Questions and comments?
The Honourable Member for Vancouver East.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker, and I thank my colleague for his comments. He raises a very valid point about the lack of consultation, and to which we've heard from a number of stakeholders who've raised concerns with respect to this bill and to say why they don't support it. That was also indicative, I think, with the number of amendments that the Speaker, at the beginning of this debate, I think he spent at least half an hour talking about it. I don't think I've gone through, as a new member really since 2015, gone through a bill where a Speaker would spend half an hour really outlining amendments to a bill to which we're debating. And so I think that's also indicative of the lack of foresight from the government side and the lack of homework, if you will, with respect to this bill. Now, having said that, one of the issues that's also central, in my view, with respect to this bill that the government did not address is the constitutionality of solitary confinements. And the BC Supreme Court and the Ontario Superior Court have ruled that it is unconstitutional to have these kinds of administrative segregation take place. So I'd like to get the comment from the member whether or not he would agree with the court decision.
The Honourable Member for Mégantic-L'Érable. As my colleague for Charlebourg-Haute-Saint-Charles